Hello there, USC Leonard Davis School of Gerontology, class of 2024. My name is John Walsh. I'm the Assistant Dean for Education. And I would like to welcome you, as would our Dean, Pinchas Cohen, to the incredible program that we have. That's it for the formalities. My name is John. You can call me Doc. Dean Cohen likes to be called Hossie. We are friends from here forward. You are part of our family. We're very approachable. If you have any questions, please email Dr. Cohen, myself, and later on, I'm going to introduce you to Associate Dean Hanke, who runs our academic program. I want to congratulate you guys for the job well done. You guys are the best of the best. USC is an incredibly competitive program, and you selecting the Leonard Davis School of Gerontology just makes our hearts swell because we are the number one program for studying gerontology, for studying every aspect of aging in the entire world. And when I say every aspect of aging, the training that you're gonna get is gonna be so applied, it's gonna be so useful that it really doesn't matter which career trajectory you choose, you're gonna have this incredible knowledge and know-how. And that knowledge and know-how is going to carry you really, really far. And it is a privilege for all of us that you have chosen us. I want to do also a shout out to your parents for the support that they have given you. You are now full-blown independent adults, and it's amazing the job they have done to nurture you to get to this point in time. I also want to encourage you to be helping out your parents at this point in time. I'm obviously giving this hello lecture, so to speak, from my home during this, my civic duty of doing social isolation. And I know all of you as well are performing your civic duty. However, this is a time for you to provide service to your friends and to your family, to your neighbors. There are a lot of people out there that are at the high risk for this COVID-19 infection. And if your parents are in their 60s, this is a good time for you to really become the adult of the house that goes out and does the shopping and then starts to manage a lot of the household duties. And I know you're already doing this, and I know it's a lot thrust upon you, but I also know you guys are ready. Okay, so what I would like to do is I'm gonna quickly take you for a tour of our program. This is not the actual website, but I just wanted to start this way so that you get a chance to formally meet myself and also to meet Hossie. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to go over to the website right here. So now I am actually in our website. And what I really would like you to do is I would like you to go ahead and navigate every aspect of this website and learn as much as you can coming in. We obviously have a lot of announcements right now that are directly relevant to our current COVID-19 pandemic and what it is that we can all do as individuals and what we're doing as a program. What I encourage you to do is go in and check out the school, okay? You can learn the history behind it, okay? You all know, again, you've chosen us as your program because you know how important gerontology is. I mean, it is all over the news right now. You know, the most vulnerable population for the COVID-19 infection are people that are older and people that have a lot of age-related conditions associated with their aging. And conditions like diabetes, obesity is a big risk factor, cancers, and a lot of different diseases, heart disease. And we specialize in this. We have an understanding of why these people are at risk. And we are doing some serious research right now trying to come up with solutions. I want you to know that we have a large group of the community that supports us, and that's who the Board of Counselors are. So I encourage you to check them out. They provide resources to all of you. They are the backbone behind the scholarships that drive our master's program. And they also provide resources so that you as individuals can do research as undergraduates. I would be remiss if I didn't start here with the staff directory. And again, Dr. Cohen is the CEO of the operation, and the rest of us are kind of like, you know, vice presidents. Okay, so I am the assistant dean of education, but I can also be called VP of education. We have Dr. Kelvin Davies, who is, as you see, the vice dean, and he oversees all aspects of research in our building. And then we have right here Maria Hanke, who is the most approachable person in our program. She runs the show. She will guide you towards success. And I encourage you to go ahead and email Maria right now and introduce yourself, and she will get you going. Now, separate from Maria, we have a whole staff devoted to your success. And that's what makes gerontology so unique. We are a big program. And so we have all kinds of different support that again, are going to be guided towards your success. And you're going to get to know all these people. Of course, student services is probably the most important thing that you're involved in. You've been likely interacting with Jim DeVera, likely interacting with Sarah Robinson, and many other of the really solid staff that help guide you. Human resources, we see that officer and the business office. And then the technology group right here. These people are incredible. They will help you in terms of navigating the different types of technologies that we use in terms of education delivery, in terms of what you need to do to be really successful, not only in education, but the research that you're gonna get involved in. And that's another topic that's super important that you should look into. And I'm sorry for that, I scrolled so quickly right there. We look at the students, okay? You as an undergraduate are just one part of this incredible academic family. We have multiple undergraduate programs. We have the programs of students that are going to be going to the health sciences. Many of you are going to go to medical school, but many of you will become physical therapists, occupational therapists, public health officials. And we have an incredible success rate. I would say that we probably have the highest hit rate of students getting into medical school of any program at USC. The master's program is really for career advancement. It's an amazing opportunity. A lot of people get a master's and also get their MD, or get a master's and go get their JD, or just use their master's. And I'll show you some of our alumni that have done well with their master's degrees. We have two totally unique PhD programs, one that focuses on biomedical aspects of aging, and the other one is more broad spectrum, kind of civil aspects, where we're looking at social sciences, psychology, and people from this other program do so amazingly well in terms of gaining professorships and academic positions all around the world. They hold really, really high positions in terms of local, state, and federal government. So it's a quite an amazing program. So I want you to check it out. Okay. All right. So of course, you're going to be guided by the faculty. And Dean Cohen is an amazing leader. He really, really has grown our program during his tenure as dean. He's also different. Most deans don't maintain an active research program. So Hasi does both, and he is there for you. You will be able to work in his laboratory. He has one of the really most well-respected laboratories that investigates the molecular biological aspects of diabetes and diseases related to diabetes in the country. I could go through each one of our faculty individually. It would take me a long time, but they are all recognized leaders for what they do. We have policy people. We have healthcare system delivery people. Murray Jacobson is a relatively new faculty member that does amazing work. Dr. Irime looks at head injuries using magnetic resonance in imaging. We have Christian Pike, who's on the forefront of Alzheimer's disease. We have Dr. Tucker Seeley, who does incredible work at the level of healthcare delivery disparities and the political side. He's an amazing advocate. On and on and on and on. We have research faculty that will work hand in hand with you in the laboratories. They're incredible. Dr. Donna Banton is is the absolute backbone of our service program, and she will help guide you to get more involved in the community. And if we do look down here, these are the instructional faculty, and you're going to get to know all these. Each one of these people are just absolute experts in the field of aging, and they bring a real neat, unique, dynamic, really diverse expertise. And you can just tell that by looking at them, the diverse perspectives that they come from. These are teaching faculty here that bring even greater expertise. We have lawyers, we have businessmen, any field that you want. Dr. Wong is an MD, who's an oncologist and hematologist. And then we have lots and lots and lots of faculty all around the campus that are joint appointments and across the world. This is one of our graduates that I'm going to discuss later, Tyler Evans, that is in the throes of what's going on right now with COVID-19. He is an infectious disease expert, and he's also a public health expert. And he has his master's in public health, he has an MD, and he has lots of other degrees that give him insight in terms of infectious disease. And his phone has been ringing off the hook. Okay, so that's our program. I just want to give you a feeling of what taking a class in gerontology is like. And I just want to, in my heart, I really hope and believe that we are going to beat this virus down, and that in fall, we're going to have an opportunity to gather and have fun together, just like we always have. And gerontology is a serious business, and you're going to get serious education, but God, we make it fun all along the way as well. All right, so this is an example of what one of my classes look like. So we are technologically savvy. We had the very first online program offered at USC. And so we are absolutely, we hit the ground running when the stay-at-home orders had occurred. So we are veterans in terms of online education. This is the website that I would use to deliver my lectures, even residential, when you're all sitting in our auditorium. And we have a pipeline of communication that you can see right here. So this is a message board that I sent out. It's called the announcement page. And so you can always go to it and be familiar with it. And then we send this out as emails. Okay, so this is a question that Aubrey had about an upcoming exam and the pathology that we were looking at. And we have this, it's like constant office hours. Here's another question with a description of what was going on with this cell in terms of fats. And there's a big focus on diet in our program. I just wanted to show this. These are the happy graduates of this course from last year. I didn't get to do this year because we had to go home and stay at home during social isolation. So this was last year at the very end of the spring semester. These are all of our pre-health majors, and all of them that took this particular class, and this class is called the Neurobiology of Aging. And we are a family, and this is these smiles that you see here. These are very sincere smiles. We are friends still to this day. And the great thing about our program is I have graduates that are from 2 years ago, last year, 6 months ago, a year, 5 years, 10 years, 20 years. Dr. Tyler Evans used to hang out in my office when he was an undergraduate. So we have this bond, which is amazing. And this is a great class. And many of these students right now have already entered medical school. Many of them have been accepted to medical school. So we have this class picture that we do all the time. Okay. I'm going to take you to another class here. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to give you a feel of what the exams are like. All right, so this right here, what I want to do is I want to go in, and I'm going to go to the current semester. So I'm going into Blackboard, and this is how you would navigate Blackboard. This is not spring, so I want to 2019. I'm going to look at 2020. So we have an exam coming up in Blackboard. Okay. But as I run this class, so this is this semester's class, again, another graduate of our program, Vanessa Okun, and these are my co-instructors that are just amazing, Tim Liu and Rhea Ashna, who've been in our program for years. As I'm up there lecturing, I will stop and I will involve you, and you'll have your computers open, and boom, we will set up and we'll say, okay, let's answer this question, okay? And so I will throw this question out, and it's a multiple choice question, and you just sit there on your computer and you answer it immediately, and then you get feedback as to whether or not you answered the question correctly, and then we look at how well the overall students did on the question, and that helps me guide my teaching. These questions also will find themselves back in the actual midterm, and so it incentivizes you to pay attention. So if I go back here again, I call this polling. So what I do is I on my end selectively open up these questions every lecture. We also do what's called a flipped classroom, and I'd like to you know, if you're in my pre-med classes, I want you to be able to read biomedical literature. So in advance, we have these readings that we set up every semester, Tim, Maria, and I. And so these are the readings, and every lecture we ask you to read half the article. And this particular article is very relevant right now in terms of inflammation. This right here is very relevant because of the current risk that populations have. Cardiovascular disease is a huge risk in terms of COVID-19 infection. And so what you do as a student is you go ahead and you would just access the article. It comes up as you see right here, and then you read the article and you read parts of it. You know, I direct you on what to do, and then you go in and you do your analysis, you do a commentary, all right, in terms of what's going on. So we can look, for example, here and see what Avishka had to say. So this was her feeling on the article, and then you see Elizabeth got in there and commented on this, okay? So again, we're very well tooled, and this is important because my students are gearing up, and what we have then, we have quizzes, so I clicked right over here. So this is the quiz that we have that is out there. Tim and Marie and I put this together. It's all done in this learning management system, which is Blackboard. Some of you may have been exposed to Canvas, which is out there by Instructure, but we use Blackboard. And this is open notes, open class. Everybody interactively does this. And then these questions will show up, some of them, not all of them, but some of them, on the midterm. Okay. So this is the upcoming midterm that the students will access. And we scroll down and we see that I made an announcement because before we had a mechanism of ensuring that the students are on their own. And this was the first midterm. The questions are randomized, or everybody gets different questions. But this one, we wanted everything to be fair. And so this is the stay-at-home exam that we have coming up on Monday. And so if you click on this again, we go enter right into the class, and then these are the questions. So the format is, again, we have lots of multiple choice questions, but that's not it. We also have lots of essay questions, and then myself and my co-instructors get in there and grade these, okay? So yes, it's awesome. All right, so we do a good job. We are very well prepared, and I just wanted to let you guys know that, okay? Now, what I wanna also, that yes, okay. I'm sorry, I just want to get out of this page. And we're going to go back to the other page. Okay, so here it is right here. So this is what we were looking at. I want to go to the announcement page because I want to also to demonstrate to you, okay, again, that we are ready. Now these are announcements, daily announcements of things that you need to go into and do in Blackboard right here. We're running the class just as always. However, we are doing it from home. And then we have Zoom lectures. So we throw up the URLs for the Zoom lectures. So, because a lot of our students are in different time zones, we have students that are in different countries. And then we copy the Zoom lectures over here to YouTube as well. And so this is a list of the lectures that we've had to do since staying home. And again, it's incredible. So, you know, we
the 29th or the 27th and the 28th.
It was
the first day.
I was cold. So I had a
birth rate like decrease a little bit.
That's Kevin just having lunch.
Not so much.
That's Gabe talking.
I mean, it's still
okay. So it's amazing what we're doing, and we have not stopped the
growing, but it's
process.
Not as.
I just want to assure you of that. Okay. So Zoom, Blackboard, that's the only thing we do. We were making it
that's
fun.
Impressive. That typo is impressive.
And right here, you see that.
Yeah, I don't know how that happened.
And this is
comprehension or what's the word?
Comprehension is
that we're doing a review for the upcoming exam. Okay, so we are dialed in. You are dialed in. Now that's not the only type of class. Obviously, the pre-med class. Okay, we also teach general education classes. We teach specialty classes in policy, specialty classes in psychology. I like to throw this one up. This is from last year. This is your family right here. These are not only gerontology students, but people are so drawn to gerontology. This is one of our GE classes. This is a large general education class called A Journey into the Mind. I am the instructor along with Tim. And you can see Tim Liu located right there. There's Maria Ashton right there. And there I am right there, okay? I have my dog shirt on here, right there, because I was trying to comfort people. Okay, so this group, I surprised them. Okay, so it's a serious class about the brain. But one day, what I did is I said, okay, I want you to come up with a business plan. I want you to come up with a marketing plan. And I'm not going to tell you what it's about. I want you to use your creative brains. And this, and we're at the same time, we were going over how we process, our brains process taste and smell. And so they didn't know what was going to happen. And what I did is I brought in a bunch of kumquats. I brought in so many kumquats. And so what they did is they created an Instagram page right here called My Kumquat. And they did this, the students, all in about a week's time. They created a marketing pamphlet describing the kumquat experience. This happened to be happening. It was going ongoing during Coachella, so they call it Coachella. Again, this was the team that made the marketing pamphlet right here. We could take a little look at a little bit more at some of the activities, the pictures right here that were happening from this. Again, and the students went all around campus and made the kumquat experience quite amazing. There's Tim Liu. Again, he's my co-instructor in this program. And again, these are all the different images from that kumquat experiment that went on. It was really, really quite incredible. Okay, awesome. So that was the Instagram page. They also made a Twitter page, all right? And communicated the kumquat experience with the world, okay? And here's USC Kumquat. They're at Coachella, okay? And it says, had a blast this weekend. That's my buddy, John Walsh, holding me up in the pit, which is awesome. And so just a lot of fun that was had with this, for sure, okay? And then the Cinematic Arts group did this, okay? And and then I'm gonna show you a video that we did earlier this year before COVID-19 hit. And it was, we as a class did a tribute to Kobe Bryant. And we'll show you how we did that. But let's take a look at this video right here. All right.
Don't eat the stem, okay?
I'm gonna take my horse to the old town road. I'm gonna ride till I can't no more. I'm gonna take my horse to the old town road. I'm gonna ride till I can't no more.
I got the horses in the back. Horse stock is attached.
He's crying.
Sour. The initial is sour. Yeah. Every single person. Riding on a tractor, lean all in my butt. Cheated on my baby. You can go and ask. My life is a movie, but riding in boots. Cowboy hat from Gucci. Wrangler on my booty.
Behind the what?
Behind the scenes.
This is my extra credit. That's
this is
here
fantastic
we go.
Content.
3% right here.
So the credits were all the cinematic arts majors and photographers that were involved in the project. The three stands for the 3% extra credit they got if they did a good job, which was awesome. And they did an amazing job, this is a again, Ryan at the end. It's kind of classic, his response.
Yes.
You got to get Zach's face.
So it was a great time. And that's what we're all about. We're going to educate you, but we're going to have fun as well. So, and I just want you guys to realize that. Okay, next. What are we going to do here? I'm going to get out of here. Sorry, my computer froze up. That's okay. All right, so let's get out of here. What else do we have going on? I want you to hear from our dean. I want you to know what he has to say about our program.
Perceptions about aging are changing dramatically. New initiatives here at the Davis School will revolutionize the field of aging.
Gerontology is really about keeping people as healthy as possible and as functional as possible, starting at a very young age.
Health span is something we're very interested in, how to prolong the period of time for which people are healthy.
You'd have less visits to the doctor, less medications that you would have to take, and so your quality of life would increase.
Over the last 40 years, there have been remarkable advances that have reshaped our understanding of aging.
Researchers here at the School of Gerontology have been at the forefront of their field for many years, from sociology to biology to psychology to public policy.
Training students to do research and getting them to generate their own ideas.
We're always thinking, what are the topics that are really going to be important? What are the scientific discoveries going to be in the next decade?
Pioneering work in the science of nutrition and aging, particularly fasting, in delaying aging and preventing age-related diseases.
Such as cancer, diabetes, heart disease. You have to consider the aging process as part of the disease.
We recently discovered a new gene in the mitochondrial DNA that seems to regulate our metabolism from the cell all the way to the body. A key factor in contributing to how we age.
Biological research with multiple genes being looked at simultaneously.
New therapies for Alzheimer's disease. The role of air pollution in accelerating the development of Alzheimer's.
Leaders in the notion of interdisciplinary research. It's an incubator of ideas. It has brought together some of the true geniuses in the field.
A truly multidisciplinary approach to the study of lifespan.
Beyond education, research, and policy, service to the community is one of our most important missions.
It's a group of people that are very much like a family who are on a mission.
It's a wonderful, wonderful place. It's a place where there is a collegial lifestyle, people getting along and really helping each other.
And there's a community that's very open-minded from a business perspective that encourages new endeavors, providing capital for those new endeavors.
In coordination and partnership with USC, we've developed a longevity training program. Gerontology really helps humanize what we do. It puts that personal wrapper around the advice and guidance that we give.
We're not set out to achieve immortality. Our goal is to go out and make people live to their full potential without being sick.
You see people really contributing to society in very different ways into their 70s and their 80s and even their 90s.
All of us are aging. One generation after another are going to need the kind of care, the research to make our lives better.
That was George Shannon. He's an amazing colleague. We also have an initiative that is taken off called Age Friendly University. And here's a little bit of a video that'll expose you to that.
The Age Friendly University is really a network of universities that have pledged that they're going to create policies and programs that are age friendly. USC was the first California university to join the Age-Friendly Global Network. Since we have done that, a couple other local institutions have joined the network as well, and we'll be working with them alongside the Los Angeles Purposeful Aging Initiative to make LA a better place to grow old.
We want to be able to...
So I encourage you to check us out in all venues of media. So this is my Facebook page, okay? And yes, I am a surfer, and I'm kind of renowned for that. But separate from that, I want to talk about a couple of our alumni. So I thought the best way would be to go to their social media site. So we'll look here at Tyler Evans' webpage. I mentioned him. He's a graduate of our program. He was the Alumni of the Year 2 years ago. And he does amazing work. So he is the chief medical officer of Santa Cruz County Health Services Agency right now, but he's done so many things. He was the national director of infectious disease for the AIDS Healthcare Foundation. He is involved in so many different things. He was a big advocate for HIV and AIDS. So he's, again, infections are his expertise. He was on the front lines for the Ebola virus. So he spent a little over a year there. So he is very, very familiar with epidemics and pandemics. So he's an incredible resource for you when you come here. There's so many different alumni that I could spend all day here, but I just want to introduce you to another one of our alumni, and that's Margarita Kekechian. Margarita is on the front lines as well. And this is Margarita sitting right here. This is her picture with her staff. Margarita is the executive director at Ararat Nursing Facility here in Southern California area. So amazing group that you're going to be exposed to. And I couldn't be more proud of you. It is my privilege that you have chosen me. It is our privilege as a program. All our professors really, really recognize that you have a lot of choice and you chose us is super meaningful. I want to end right here with my family photo here. So this is Instagram for the horn section in the marching band. That's my son right there, David Walsh. And he is a freshman this year. And so I'm wearing a USC t-shirt, but I'm going to stand up. See, it's the USC band because the band is awesome. And you will enjoy every aspect of pregame activities and just the band in general. It's just an amazing group. So I wish you all well. I encourage you to contact me. I encourage you to contact Dr. Henke. Maria Henke, the associate director, and I also encourage you to contact Hasse. So with that, I'm going to say goodbye. I'm going to say fight on, and we'll see you soon.